CDC findings showed how COVID-19 is really transmitted. Decreasing transmission risk in communities is key in combating this pandemic. But what's the science behind indoor or surface transmission? Can you get COVID-19 from surfaces where the coronavirus landed recently? According to the US Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, transmission from surfaces remains low when compared to airborne droplets. People are more likely to contract the disease via exposure to droplets produced by coughing, sneezing, singing, talking, and other similar means. So, are surfaces unlikely to carry the coronavirus? To better answer that, the CDC explained that SARS-CoV-2, the virus that causes COVID-19, is an enveloped virus. Its genetic material is kept inside an outer layer called an envelope, made up of proteins and lipids. The envelope itself has the structures or spike proteins required to infect human cells. Similar to other known enveloped respiratory viruses, the envelope of SARS-CoV-2 degrades quickly upon contact with surfactants, which are commonly found in detergents and other cleaning agents. The envelope may also degrade quickly in specific environmental conditions. To increase the chance of getting COVID-19 from fomites or contaminated objects, certain factors must be off the charts, such as a high prevalence of COVID-19 in the community, excessive levels of viral particles, high accumulation of expelled viral particles onto surfaces, and current environmental factors. The CDC analyzed these subjects in quantitative microbial risk assessment studies. Researchers found that the risk of getting COVID-19 via fomite transmission is low, around less than 1 in 10,000 chances. However, the estimate still needs more data to improve its accuracy. For an average person, they need to understand the elements that may influence the virus levels on objects. First, face masks greatly reduce the amount of viral particles people can expel. Second, very good ventilation inside your home hinders the virus from accumulating on surfaces. Third, heat and evaporation can damage the virus and reduce its stability on surfaces. Fourth, the time gap between contamination and someone touching the surface. And fifth, touching one's face after touching the surface without washing their hands properly. To ease the mind from contamination, the CDC advises using soap or detergent to clean surfaces often touched by people. You may also consider yourself as an object if you went outside. Thus, taking a shower as soon as you return home is recommended. Hospitals, on the other hand, are likely to use stronger cleaners because they are high-risk places. If you want to disinfect, only use disinfectants registered to the Environmental Protection Agency.